In this question, it is given that A and B are the roots of x square minus 3x plus b is equal to 0 and C and D are the roots of x square minus 12x plus q is equal to 0 where A, B, C and D form a geometric progression. Then you need to prove that q plus p is to q minus p is equal to 17:15. Let's see the solution of this problem, how we shall proceed with this. We are given A and B are the roots of x square minus 3x plus p is equal to 0. Implies sum of the roots is equal to a plus b is equal to minus b by a, that is minus of minus 3 upon 1 is equal to 3. Therefore we have a plus b is equal to 3. Product of the roots is equal to ab is equal to c by a, that is p upon 1 is equal to p. Therefore we have ab is equal to p. We are also given c and d are the roots of x square minus 12x plus q is equal to 0. Implies sum of the roots is equal to c plus d is equal to minus b by a, that is minus of minus 12 upon 1 is equal to 12. Therefore we have c plus d is equal to 12. Product of the roots is equal to cd is equal to c by a, that is q upon 1 is equal to q. Therefore we have cd is equal to q. We are given ABCD form a geometric progression. Let small r be the common ratio of the geometric progression. Therefore we have A is equal to A, the first term, B is equal to A into R, C is equal to A into R square and D is equal to A into R cube. Since we have a plus b is equal to 3 and ab is equal to p, also we have c plus d is equal to 12 and cd is equal to q, implies we have the value of a is a itself and b is equal to ar. Therefore this will be a plus ar is equal to 3 and also a into ar is equal to p. In a similar way, we have the value of c as ar square and d as ar cube. So this will be ar square plus ar cube is equal to 12. Also we have cd is equal to q, that means ar square into ar cube is equal to q. Now if you take a common in this, inside the bracket it will be 1 plus r is equal to 3, and here we have a into a, that is a square into r is equal to p. Now here if you take ar square common in this, inside the bracket it will be 1 plus r is equal to 12, and if you multiply these two you will be getting a square into r to the power 5 is equal to q. Therefore we have a into 1 plus r is equal to 3. We call this as equation 1. Also we have ar square into 1 plus r is equal to 12. Let this be equation 2. Also we have a square into r is equal to p. Let this be equation 3. Also we have a square into r to the power 5 is equal to q. Let this be equation 4. Now, on dividing the second equation by first equation, we get ar square into 1 plus r upon a into 1 plus r is equal to 12 by 3. So on simplifying this, you will be getting r square is equal to 4. Let us take this as equation 5. Now, On dividing the fourth equation by third equation, we get, we have the fourth equation as a square into r to the power 5 is equal to q. So we have a square into r to the power 5 upon the third equation is a square r. So this will be a square r is equal to q upon p. Now you can cancel out this a square here. Also you can cancel out this r in r to the power 5, r to the power 4 times. Therefore we have q by p is equal to r to the power 4. And this r to the power 4 can be written as r square whole square. Since from fifth equation the value of r square is equal to 4. So this will be 4 whole square is equal to 16. This has come from equation 5. In place we have q by p is equal to 16, or you can say q is equal to 16p. Now let us take the left hand side of the result. We have the left hand side is equal to q plus p is to q minus p, and this can be written as q plus p upon q minus p. We got the value of q as 16p. So this will be 16p plus p upon 16p minus p. So this is equal to 17p upon 15p. Now you can cancel out p here. So this is equal to 17 upon 15, or you can write this as 17 is to 15, which is the right hand side of the result. Therefore we have the left hand side is equal to right hand side. So this completes the solution. In this problem, it is given that the ratio of the arithmetic mean and the geometric mean of two positive numbers a and b is m is to n. Then you need to show that a is to b is equal to m plus square root of m square minus n square is to m minus square root of m square minus n square. Let's see the solution of this problem, how we shall proceed with this. We are given two positive numbers a and b. Let us assume that a is greater than b, greater than 0. We are also given the arithmetic mean of two positive numbers a and b is to geometric mean of the same is equal to m is to n. We know that the arithmetic mean of a and b is a plus b by 2 is to the geometric mean is square root of ab is equal to m is to n. Implies this can also be written as a plus b by 2 upon square root of ab is equal to m by n. Implies we have a plus b upon 2 into square root of ab is equal to m by n. Now, on squaring the both sides, you will be getting a plus b whole square upon 4 into ab is equal to m square upon n square. Implies a plus b whole square is equal to 4ab into m square upon n square. Now, taking square root on both sides, you will be getting a plus b is equal to 2 into square root of AB into M upon N. So let us take this as equation 1. We know that A minus B whole square is equal to A plus B whole square minus 4AB. Implies we have A minus B whole square is equal to 4 into AB into M square upon N square minus 4 into AB. So this can be written as 4AB into M square minus 4AB into N square upon N square. Now, you can take 4AB common in this numerator. So inside the bracket, we will be having M square minus N square upon N square. Therefore, if you take square root on both sides, you will be getting A minus B is equal to 2 into square root of AB into square root of M square minus N square upon N. So let us take this as equation 2. Now, on adding 1 and 2, we get A plus B plus A minus B is equal to 2 into square root of AB into M upon N plus, from second equation we have 2 into square root of AB into square root of M square minus N square upon N. Here, this plus B and minus B will get cancelled. So this will be A plus A, that is 2A is equal to, if you take 2 root AB upon N as a common term, so inside the bracket we will be getting M plus square root of M square minus N square. Now we can cancel this 2 on both sides. So this implies the value of A is equal to square root of AB upon N into, we have M plus square root of M square minus N square. So let us take this as equation 3. Now we got the value of A, now we need to find out the value of B. For that sake, let us substitute equation 3 in first equation. We have the first equation, that is A plus B is equal to 2 into square root of AB into M upon N. Now, on substituting the value of A, we will be getting of M square minus N square plus B is equal to 2 into square root of AB into M upon N. Now, on transposing this term to the right hand side, we will be getting the value of B as 2 into square root of AB into M upon N minus square root of AB upon N into, inside the bracket, we have M plus square root of M square minus N square. So this is equal to, in these two terms, we have square root of AB upon N is common. So inside the bracket, it will be 2M minus of M plus square root of M square minus N square. So this can be simplified as square root of AB upon N into, this can be written as 2M minus M minus of square root of M square minus N square. So on further simplification, this can be written as square root of AB upon N into M minus square root of M square minus N square. So this is the value of B. So let us take this as equation 4. Now we need to find out A is to B. For that sake, we have to divide the third equation by fourth equation. Implies a by b is equal to square root of ab upon n into m plus square root of m square minus n square whole divided by square root of ab upon n into m minus square root of m square minus n square. Now you can cancel out this term both in the numerator and denominator. So this implies we have a by b is equal to m plus square root of m square minus n square upon m minus square root of m square minus n square. Hence we have a is to b is equal to m plus square root of m square minus n square is to m minus square root of m square minus n square. So this completes the solution. In this problem, it is given that A, B and C are in arithmetic progression, whereas B, C and D are in geometric progression, and 1 by C, 1 by D and 1 by E are in arithmetic progression, then you need to prove that A, C and E are in geometric progression. Let's see the solution of this problem. We are given A, B and C are in arithmetic progression. Implies B minus A is equal to C minus B. Or you can write this as 2B is equal to A plus C. Or B is equal to A plus C by 2. So let us take this as equation 1. Now, it is given that B, C and D are in geometric progression. Implies the condition is C square is equal to BD. So let us take this as equation 2. Now it is also given that 1 by C, 1 by D and 1 by E are in arithmetic progression. Implies 1 by D minus 1 by C is equal to 1 by E minus 1 by D. Implies 2 by D is equal to 1 by E plus 1 by C. Implies 2 by D is equal to C plus E upon CE. Implies the value of D is equal to 2 into CE upon C plus E. Let us take this as equation 3. Now, we need to prove that AC and E are in geometric progression. That means, to prove that AC and E are in geometric progression, it is enough if we prove that C square is equal to AE. Now, from second equation, we have C square is equal to BD. Now, from first equation, we have B is equal to A plus C by 2 multiplied by the value of D from our third equation is 2 into CE upon C plus E. So let us write it here, 2 into CE upon C plus E. Now you can cancel out this 2 here. So this is equal to, we have A plus C into CE upon C plus E. Is equal to C square. So this implies, on cross multiplication, you will be having C square into C plus E is equal to A plus C into CE. Now we can cancel out this C on both sides. So this implies we have C into C plus E is equal to A plus C into E. So this implies we have, on multiplication we will be getting C square plus CE is equal to AE plus CE. Now you can cancel out the CE on both sides. So this implies we have C square is equal to AE. So based on this, we conclude that AC and E are in geometric progression. So this completes the solution. In this problem, you need to find out the sum of the following series up to n terms. Let's see the solution of this problem, how we shall proceed with this. First of all, we shall start with the first part of the problem. Let Sn is equal to 5 plus 55 plus 555 plus so on up to n terms. Now, let us divide and multiply this series by 9. Then you will be getting 5 by 9 into 9 plus 99 plus 999 plus so on up to n terms. So this is equal to 5 by 9 into this 9 can be written as 10 minus 1 plus this 99 can be written as 100 minus 1 plus this 999 can be written as 1000 minus 1 plus so on up to n terms. So this is equal to 5 by 9 into inside the bracket we have 10 minus 1 plus 10 square minus 1 plus 10 cube minus 1 plus so on up to n terms. So this is equal to 5 by 9 into, let us write the series of 10 together, that is 10 plus 10 square plus 10 cube plus so on up to n terms minus of 1 plus 1 plus 1 and so on up to n terms. So this is a geometric series whose first term is 10 and the common ratio, that is r, is equal to second term upon first term, that is 10 square upon 10, which gives us 10. So this is equal to 5 by 9 into, we have 10 into 10 to the power n minus 1 upon 10 minus 1 minus 1 plus 1 plus 1 and so on up to n terms will give us n. Since we know that the sum to n terms of the geometric progression is Sn is equal to A into r raised to the power n minus 1 upon r minus 1. So this is equal to 5 by 9 into, in the numerator we have 10 to the power n plus 1 minus 10 upon 10 minus 1 is 9 minus n. So this is equal to 5 by 9 into 10 to the power n plus 1 minus 10 minus 9n upon 9. So this is equal to 5 by 81 into 10 to the power n plus 1 minus 10 minus 9n. Hence, the sum of the given series, that is 5 plus 55 plus 555 plus so on up to n terms, is equal to 5 by 81 into 10 to the power n plus 1 minus 10 minus 9n. So this completes the first part. Now, let us move on to the second part of the problem. Let the given series be Sn is equal to 0.6 plus 0.66 plus 0.666 plus so on up to n terms. So this is equal to, if you take 6 common in this series, you will be getting 0.1 plus 0.11 plus 0.111 plus so on up to n terms. Now let us divide and multiply this series by 9. Then you will be getting 6 by 9 into 0.9 plus 0.99 plus 0.999 plus so on up to n terms. So this is equal to 6 by 9 into this 0.9 can be written as 1 minus 0.1 plus 0.99 can be written as 1 minus 0.01 plus 0.999 can be written as 1 minus 0.001 plus so on up to n terms. Now you can cancel out 3 in this. So this is equal to, we have 2 by 3 into inside the bracket. Let us write all the ones together, that is 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus so on up to n terms. Minus of 0.1 plus 0.01 plus 0.001 plus so on up to n terms. So this is equal to 2 by 3 into 1 plus 1 plus 1 and so on up to n terms will give us n minus of, here this is a geometric progression whose first term is 0.1 and the common ratio is 0.01 upon 0.1, which gives us 0.1, and the sum to n terms is given by 0.1 into 1 minus 0.1 whole to the power n upon 1 minus 0.1. Since we know that when r is less than 1, the sum to n terms of the geometric progression is equal to a into 1 minus r to the power n upon 1 minus r. So this can be written as 2 by 3 into, we have n minus, this 0.1 can be written as 1 by 10 into 1 minus 1 by 10 whole to the power n upon 1 minus 1 by 10. So this is equal to 2 by 3 into n minus 1 by 10 into 1 minus 1 by 10 to the power n upon 10 minus 1 upon 10. So this is equal to 2 by 3 into n minus 1 by 10 into 1 minus 1 by 10 to the power n into 10 upon 9. Now you can cancel out this 10 here. So this is equal to 2 by 3 into n minus 1 by 9 into 1 minus 1 by 10 raised to the power n. Hence, we have the series as 0.6 plus 0.66 plus 0.666 plus so on up to n terms is equal to 2 by 3 into n minus 1 by 9 into 1 minus 1 by 10 raised to the power n. So this completes the solution. In this problem, you need to find out the 20th term of the series 2 into 4 plus 4 into 6 plus 6 into 8 plus so on up to n terms. Let's see the solution of this problem, how we shall proceed with this. Given series is 2 into 4 plus 4 into 6 plus 6 into 8 plus so on up to n terms. Now, to find out the 20th term, we need to have nth term. So, first of all, the first sequence what we have is 2, 4, 6 and so on. These are in AP. We know that nth term is equal to AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D, where A is the first term and D is the common difference. So based on this formula, let us find out the nth term for this sequence. So this is equal to, here the first term is 2 plus n minus 1 into common difference is 4 minus 2, that is 2. So this will be 2 plus 2n minus 2. Now you can cancel out this plus 2 and minus 2. So this gives us 2n. Hence, the nth term of the first sequence is 2n. Here, the other sequence, that is 4, 6, 8 and so on, are in AP. Here, nth term an is equal to 4 plus n minus 1 into common difference is 6 minus 4, that is 2. So this will be 4 plus 2n minus 2 is equal to 2n plus 2. Therefore, the nth term of the series is equal to 2n into 2n plus 2. So on multiplying this, you will be getting 2n into 2n, that is 4n square, plus 2n into 2, that is 4n. Therefore, the nth term of the series, that is an, is equal to 4n square plus 4n. Now, we need to find out the 20th term of the series. Therefore, put n is equal to 20. That means 20th term is equal to a20 is equal to 4 into 20 whole square plus 4 into 20. So this is equal to 4 into 20 square is 400 plus 4 into 20, that is 80. So this gives us 1600 plus 80. So this gives us 1680. Hence, the 20th term of the given series is 1680. So this completes the solution. In this question, you need to find out the sum of first n terms of the series 3 plus 7 plus 13 plus 21 plus so on. Let's see the solution of this problem, how we shall proceed with this. Given series is 3 plus 7 plus 13 plus 21 plus so on. Now observe the difference of terms here. Second term minus first term, that is 7 minus 3 is 4. 13 minus 7 is 6. 21 minus 13 is 8. 31 minus 21 is 10 and so on. That means the difference is not same throughout the series. Let an denotes the nth term and Sn denotes the sum of the first n terms of the series. Therefore, Sn is equal to 3 plus 7 plus 13 plus 21 plus so on plus an minus 1 plus an. Let us take this as equation 1. Now let us write the Sn again by writing second term below first term, third term below second term, and so on. Let us take this as equation 2. Now, on subtracting the second equation from first equation, we get 3 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus so on up to n terms minus an is equal to 0. Now, transposing this an to the right hand side, you will be getting an is equal to 3 plus, put separate bracket for this, 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus so on up to n minus 1 terms. Now observe this. This is an arithmetic progression with the first term is equal to a and the common difference is equal to 6 minus 4 is equal to 2. So this is equal to 3 plus the sum of n minus 1 terms is given by n minus 1 upon 2 into 2 into a, that is 2 into 4 plus n minus 1 into d, that is n minus 1 minus 1 into the value of d is 2. So this is equal to 3 plus n minus 1 upon 2 into 8 plus n minus 2 into 2. So this is equal to 3 plus n minus 1 upon 2 into, if you take 2 common here, then inside the bracket you will be getting 4 plus n minus 2. Now you can cancel out this 2 here. So this implies we have 3 plus n minus 1 into, on simplifying this you will be getting n plus 2. So this is equal to 3 plus, on multiplying this you will be getting n square plus 2n minus n, that is plus n minus 2. So this is equal to n square plus n plus 1. Therefore we have the nth term, that is an, is equal to n square plus n plus 1. But we need to find out the sum of first n terms of this series. Since Sn represents the sum of n terms of this series, of the given series, therefore Sn is equal to summation an. So this can be written as summation n square plus n plus 1. So this is equal to summation n square plus summation n plus summation 1. So this is equal to, we know that summation n square is n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 upon 6 plus summation n is n into n plus 1 by 2 plus summation 1 is n. So this is equal to, if you take n common in these three terms, you will be getting n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 upon 6 plus, here we have n plus 1 upon 2 plus 1. So this is equal to n into, on taking the LCM you will be getting n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 plus 3 into n plus 1 plus 6 upon 6. So this is equal to n into, in the first two terms we have n plus 1, the term n plus 1 is common. If you take n plus 1 common here, then inside the bracket you will be getting 2n plus 1 plus 3 plus 6 upon 6. So this is equal to n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 4 plus 6 upon 6. So this is equal to n by 6 into, inside the bracket we will be having 2n square plus 4n plus 2n, that is plus 6n plus 4 plus 6. So this is equal to n by 6 into, here we have 2n square plus 6n plus 10. So this is equal to n by 6 into, if you take 2 common here, then inside the bracket you will be getting n square plus 3n plus 5. So on simplifying this, you will be getting n by 3 into n square plus 3n plus 5. Hence, the sum of the first n terms of the given series is n by 3 into n square plus 3n plus 5. So this completes the solution. In this question, it is given that S1, S2, S3 are the sum of first n natural numbers, their squares and their cubes, respectively, then you need to show that 9s2 square is equal to s3 into 1 plus 8s1. Let's see the solution of this problem. How we shall proceed with this? We are given s1 is equal to sum of the first n natural numbers. Implies s1 is equal to the summation n, which is equal to n into n plus 1 by 2. So let us take this as 1. S2 is equal to sum of the squares of the first n natural numbers. Implies S2 is equal to the summation n square, which is equal to n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 upon 6. You have to remember this formula. Let us take this as 2. S3 is equal to sum of the cubes of the first n natural numbers. Implies S3 is equal to summation n cube, which is equal to n square into n plus 1 whole square upon 4. Therefore, we have S3 is equal to n square into n plus 1 whole square upon 4. You have to remember this. We shall take this as 3. Now, we need to prove this result. Now, let us take the right hand side of the result. That is, we have S3 into 1 plus 8S1. So, this is equal to S3 is n square into n plus 1 whole square upon 4 multiplied by, we have 1 plus 8 into s1 is n into n plus 1 upon 2. Here you can cancel out this 2 in 8, 4 times. So this is equal to n square into n plus 1 whole square upon 4 into, here we have 1 plus 4 n into n plus 1. So this is equal to n square into n plus 1 whole square upon 4 into, here we have 4n square plus 4n plus 1. So this is equal to n square into n plus 1 whole square into, this is the expansion of 2n plus 1 whole square upon 4. Now, in order to get s2 square on the left hand side, we need to multiply and divide this term by 9. So this is equal to n square into n plus 1 whole square into 2n plus 1 whole square upon 4 into 9 by 9. So this is equal to, we have 9 into n square into n plus 1 whole square into 2n plus 1 whole square upon 4 into 9, that is 36. So this can be written as 9 into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 upon 6 whole square. So this is equal to 9 into, this can be written as s2 whole square. Since from second equation we have s2 is equal to n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 upon 6. So this is equal to the left hand side of the result. Therefore, we have left hand side is equal to right hand side. So this completes the solution. This problem says you need to find out the sum of the following series up to n terms. Let's see the solution of this problem, how we shall proceed with this. Given series is 1 cube upon 1 plus 1 cube plus 2 cube upon 1 plus 3 plus 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube upon 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus so on up to n terms. Therefore, the nth term of the series is equal to an is equal to 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube plus so on plus n cube upon 1 plus 3 plus 5 and so on up to n. So this is equal to, in the numerator we have the sum of the cubes of the first n natural numbers, which can be represented by summation n cube upon the sum of the odd terms up to n. So this is equal to summation n cube upon the sum of odd terms is given by n by 2 into 2 into the first term is 1 plus n minus 1 into the common difference is 3 minus 1, that is 2. So this is equal to summation n cube upon n by 2 into 2 plus 2n minus 2. So this is equal to summation n cube upon, here we will be having n by 2 into 2n. Now you can cancel out this 2 here. So this implies summation n cube upon n square. We know that summation n cube is equal to n square into n plus 1 whole square upon 4. So let us substitute this. Here we have n square into n plus 1 whole square upon 4 upon n square. So this is equal to n square into n plus 1 whole square upon 4n square. Now we can cancel out this n square here. So this is equal to n plus 1 whole square upon 4. Or you can write this as 1 by 4 into, on expanding this, you will be getting n square plus 2n plus 1. Therefore, we have the nth term, that is an is equal to 1 by 4 into n square plus 2n plus 1. Now, the sum to n terms is equal to Sn is equal to summation An. So this is equal to summation 1 by 4 into n square plus 2n plus 1. So this is equal to, since 1 by 4 is a constant, you can write this outside into summation of n square plus 2n plus 1. So this is equal to, we have 1 by 4 into, this can be written as summation n square plus 2 into summation n plus summation 1. So this is equal to 1 by 4 into summation n square is n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 upon 6 plus 2 into, here we have summation n, that is n into n plus 1 upon 2 plus here we have sigma 1, that is n. Now you can cancel out this 2 here. So this is equal to 1 by 4 into, here we have n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 plus 6 into n plus 1 plus 6n upon 6. So this is equal to, in the numerator we have a common term, that is n. So let us write this as n by 4 into, inside the bracket you will be having n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 plus 6 into n plus 1 plus 6 upon 6. So this is equal to n by 24 into, here on multiplying these two you will be getting 2n square plus 3n plus 1 plus here we have 6n plus 6 plus 6. So this is equal to n by 24 into 2n square plus 3n plus 6n, that is plus 9n plus 13. Hence the sum of the series up to n terms is n by 24 into 2n square plus 9n plus 13. So this completes the solution. In this problem you need to show that this result is equal to 3n plus 5 upon 3n plus 1. Let's see the solution of this problem, how we shall proceed with this. Here we have the left hand side is equal to 1 into 2 square plus 2 into 3 square plus so on plus n into n plus 1 whole square upon 1 square into 2 plus 2 square into 3 plus so on plus n square into n plus 1. So this can be written as summation n into n plus 1 whole square whole divided by summation n square into n plus 1. So this is equal to summation n into, if we expand this n plus 1 whole square, it will be n square plus 2n plus 1 upon summation. Here we have n square into n, that is n cube, plus n square into 1, that is n square. So this is equal to, we have summation n cube plus 2n square plus n upon summation of n cube plus n square. So this is equal to summation n cube plus 2 into summation n square plus summation n upon summation n cube plus here we have summation n square. So this is equal to, we know that summation n cube is n square into n plus 1 whole square upon 4 plus here we have 2 into summation n square is n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 upon 6 plus here we have summation n, that is n into n plus 1 upon 2 whole divided by summation n cube. Again we have n square into n plus 1 whole square upon 4 plus here we have summation n square, that is n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 upon 6. Now observe here, in the numerator we have n into n plus 1 by 2 is a common term in these three terms, and in the denominator also we have n into n plus 1 by 2 as a common term. So this is equal to, if we take n into n plus 1 by 2 as a common term, then inside the bracket we will be getting n into n plus 1 by 2 plus here we have 2 into 2n plus 1 upon 3 plus 1 whole divided by If you take n into n plus 1 by 2 as common term in the denominator, then you will be getting n into n plus 1 by 2 plus here we will be getting 2n plus 1 upon 3. Now you can cancel out this n into n plus 1 by 2 in the numerator and denominator. So this is equal to, here we have 6 is the LCM and in the numerator 3n into n plus 1 plus 4 into 2n plus 1 plus 6 whole divided by, if you take 6 as LCM in the denominator, you will be getting 3n into n plus 1 plus 2 into 2n plus 1. Now you can cancel out this 6 here. So this is equal to 3n into n square, that is 3n square plus 3n plus 8n plus 4 plus 6 upon, here we have 3n square plus 3n plus 4n plus 2. So this is equal to 3n square plus 11n plus 10 whole divided by 3n square plus 7n plus 2. So this is equal to, if we factorize the numerator, you will be getting 3n plus 5 into n plus 2 upon. In a similar way, if you factorize the denominator, you will be getting 3n plus 1 into n plus 2. So you can cancel out this n plus 2 here. So what we are left with? 3n plus 5 upon 3n plus 1, which is equal to the right hand side of the result. Therefore, left hand side is equal to right hand side. So this completes the solution. In this question, it is given that a farmer buys a used tractor for rupees 12,000. He pays rupees 6,000 in cash and agrees to pay the balance in annual installments of rupees 500 plus 12% interest on the unpaid amount. Now you need to find out how much does the tractor cost to him. Let's see the solution of this problem, how we shall proceed with this. We are given the original cost of the used tractor is equal to rupees 12,000. Amount paid by cash is equal to rupees 6,000. Therefore, the total unpaid amount is equal to 12,000 minus 6,000 is equal to 6,000. Each annual installment is equal to rupees 500. We are given the rate of interest is equal to 12% per annum. Interest paid along with the first installment is equal to interest on rupees 6,000 for 1 year at the rate of 12% interest is equal to 6,000 into 12/100. So on simplifying this, you will be getting 720. Interest paid along with the second installment is equal to interest on rupees 5,500 for 1 year at the rate of 12%. which is equal to ₹5,500 into 12/100. On simplifying this, you will be getting ₹660. Similarly, the interest paid along with the third installment is equal to interest on ₹5,000 for 1 year at the rate of 12%, which is equal to ₹5,000 into 12/100. So this gives us 600, and so on. Now let us find out the interest paid along with the 12th installment, which is equal to interest on ₹500 for 1 year at the rate of 12%, which is equal to ₹500 into 12/100. This gives 60. Therefore, the sequence of interest paid at the end of every year is 720, 660, 600, and so on up to 60. The above sequence is an arithmetic progression, with the first term is equal to A is equal to 720. Common difference is equal to D is equal to second term minus first term, that is 660 minus 720, which gives us minus 60. And number of terms is equal to N is equal to 12. Therefore, the total interest paid is equal to ₹720 plus 660 plus 600 plus so on up to 60. We know that the sum to n terms of the arithmetic progression is Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d, where a is the first term, d is the common difference, and n is the number of terms. Therefore, we have S12 is equal to 12 by 2 into 2 into the first term is 720 plus 12 minus 1 into the common difference is minus 60. So on simplifying this, you will be getting 6 into 1440 minus 11 into 60. So this is equal to 6 into 1440 minus 660. So this is equal to 6 into 780. So on multiplying this, you will be getting 4680. Therefore, the total cost of the tractor is equal to ₹12,000 plus ₹4,680, which gives us 16,680. Hence, the total cost of the tractor is ₹16,680. So this completes the solution. In this question, it is given that Shamshad Ali buys a scooter for ₹22,000. He pays ₹4,000 cash and agrees to pay the balance in annual installment of ₹1,000 plus 10% interest on the unpaid amount. Now, you need to find out how much does the scooter cost him. Let's see the solution of this problem, how we shall proceed with this. We are given the cost of the scooter is equal to ₹22,000. Amount paid by cash is equal to ₹4,000. Therefore, the total unpaid amount is equal to ₹22,000 minus 4,000 is equal to ₹18,000. Each annual installment is equal to ₹1,000. Rate of interest is equal to 10% per annum. Total number of installments is equal to 18,000 upon 1,000 is equal to 18. Interest paid along with the first installment is equal to interest on ₹18,000 for 1 year at the rate of 10% per annum, which is equal to 18,000 into 10/100. Which gives us 1800. Interest paid along with the second installment is equal to interest on ₹17,000 for 1 year at the rate of 10%, which is equal to 17,000 into 10/100, which gives us ₹1,700. And so on. Now, we shall find out the interest paid along with the last installment, that is 18th installment, which is equal to interest on ₹1,000 at the rate of 10%, which is equal to 1,000 into 10/100 is equal to 100. Therefore, the sequence of total interest paid is ₹1,800, ₹1,700, and so on, and ₹100. This sequence forms an arithmetic progression with the first term is equal to A is equal to 1800. Common difference is equal to D is equal to second term minus first term, that is minus 100. Number of terms is equal to N is equal to 18. Therefore, the total interest paid is equal to ₹1,800 plus 1,700 plus so on up to 18 terms. We know that the sum to n terms of the arithmetic progression is Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Therefore, based on this formula, S18 is equal to 18 upon 2 into 2 into the first term is 1800 plus 18 minus 1 into the value of d is minus 100. So on simplifying this, you will be getting 9 into 3600 minus 17 into 100. So this is equal to 9 into 3600 minus 1700. So this is equal to 9 into 1900. Is equal to 17,100. Therefore, the total cost of the scooter is equal to ₹22,000 plus 17,100 is equal to ₹39,100. Hence, the total cost of the scooter is ₹39,100. So this completes the solution. This question says, a person writes a letter to four of his friends. He asks each one of them to copy the letter and mail to four different persons with the instruction that they move the chain similarly. Assuming that the chain is not broken and that it costs 50 pice to mail one letter, then you need to find out the amount spent on the postage when 8th set of letter is mailed. Let's see the solution of this problem, how we shall proceed with this. As per the problem, the total number of letters posted is equal to 4 plus 4 into 4 plus 4 into 4 into 4 plus so on up to 8 terms. So this is equal to, here we have 4 plus 4 square plus 4 cube plus so on up to 8 terms. Therefore, this series is a geometric progression with the first term is equal to A is equal to 4. Common ratio is equal to second term upon first term is equal to 4. And the number of terms is equal to n is equal to 8. We know that the sum to n terms of the geometric progression is Sn is equal to A into r to the power n minus 1 upon r minus 1, where A is the first term and r is the common ratio. Therefore, we have S8 is equal to the value of A, that is 4 into 4 to the power 8 minus 1 upon 4 minus 1. So, this is equal to 4 by 3 into 4 to the power 8 minus 1. So, this is equal to 4 by 3 into 4 to the power 8 is 65,536 minus 1. So this is equal to 4 by 3 into, here we will be getting 65,535. So on simplifying this, you will be getting 4 into 21,845. So on multiplying this, you will be getting 87,380. Therefore, the total number of letters posted is equal to 87,380. Now, we need to find out the total amount spent on the postage. And it is given that it costs 50 pice to mail one letter. Therefore, the amount spent on postage is equal to 87,380 multiplied by 50 pice, that is 0.50. So this is equal to, on multiplying this, you will be getting rupees 43,690. Hence, the amount spent on the postage when the 8th set of letter is mailed is rupees 43,690. So this completes the solution. This problem says a man deposited rupees 10,000 in a bank at the rate of 5% simple interest annually. Now you need to find out the amount in 15th year since he deposited the amount, and also you need to calculate the total amount after 20 years. Let's see the solution of this problem, how we shall proceed with this. We are given the amount deposited in the bank is equal to rupees 10,000. Rate of simple interest is equal to 5% per annum. Now, we shall find out the interest at the end of 1 year. is equal to PTR by 100, where the principal is equal to 10,000, time period is 1 year, and rate of interest is 5%, so 5 upon 100. So this gives us rupees 500. Therefore, the amount paid by bank at the end of 1 year is equal to rupees 10,000 plus the interest, that is 500, is equal to 10,500. In a similar way, the amount paid by bank at the end of 2 years is equal to rupees 10,000 plus 10,000 into the time period is 2 years and rate of interest is 5%, so this will be 5 upon 100. So on simplifying this, you will be getting rupees 10,000 plus 1,000, which gives us rupees 11,000. In a similar way, the amount paid by bank at the end of 3 years is equal to rupees 10,000 plus 10,000 into the time period is 3 years and rate of interest is 5%. So this will be 5 upon 100. So this is equal to rupees 10,000 plus 1500. So this gives us rupees 11,500. And so on. Thus, the amounts paid by bank at the end of successive years are 10,500, 11,000, 11,500, and so on. Therefore, we have this sequence is an arithmetic progression with the first term is equal to A is equal to 10,500. Common difference is equal to D is equal to second term minus first term. That is, we have 11,000 minus 10,500. So this gives us rupees 500. Therefore, the amount in the 15th year is equal to the amount paid by bank at the end of 14th year. We know that the nth term of the arithmetic progression is an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d, where a is the first term and d is the common difference. So based on this formula, let us find out a14. a14 is equal to the value of a is 10,500. So let us substitute here 10,500 plus 14 minus 1 into the value of d is 500. So this is equal to 10,500 plus 13 into 500. So this is equal to 10,500 plus 6,500. So on adding these two, you will be getting rupees 17,000. Similarly, the amount at the end of 20 years is equal to A20. Implies A20 is equal to, we have the first term as 10,500 plus 20 minus 1 into the common difference is 500. So this is equal to 10,500 plus 19 into 500. So this is equal to 10,500 plus, on multiplying these two, we will be getting 9,500. So on adding these two, we will be getting 20,000. Hence, the amount in 15th year is rupees 17,000, as we have discussed here. Also, the amount after 20 years is rupees 20,000. So this completes the solution. This problem says a manufacturer reckons that the value of a machine which costs him rupees 15,625 will depreciate each year by 20%. Now you need to find out the estimated value at the end of 5 years. Let's see the solution of this problem, how we shall proceed with this. We are given the cost of the machine is equal to rupees 15,625. We are also given the depreciation per year is equal to 20%. Therefore, the cost of the machine at the end of 1 year is equal to rupees 15,625 minus 15,625 into 20/100. So this can also be written as 15,625 into 1 minus 20/100. So this is equal to 15,625 into 80/100. So this is equal to 15,625 into 4/5. Therefore we have the cost of the machine at the end of 1 year is equal to 15,625 into 4/5. In a similar way, the cost of the machine at the end of 2 years is equal to rupees 15,625 into 4/5 whole square. And so on. Therefore, the cost of the machine at the end of each year forms a geometric progression. And the sequence will be 15,625 into 4/5, 15,625 into 4/5 whole square, 15,625 into 4/5 whole cube, and so on. Here we have the first term is equal to A is equal to 15,625 into 4/5. Common ratio is equal to small r is equal to second term upon first term, which gives us 4/5. We know that the nth term in the geometric progression is an is equal to a into r to the power n minus 1, where a is the first term and r is the common ratio. Therefore, the cost of the machine at the end of 5 years is equal to A5 is equal to A into R to the power 5 minus 1, that is 4. So this will be A into R to the power 4. So this is equal to, since the value of A is 15,625 into 4/5 multiplied by the value of R is 4/5 raised to the power 4. So this is equal to 15,625 into 4/5 whole to the power 5. So this is equal to, this 15,625 can be written as 5 to the power 6 into this 4/5 whole to the power 5 can be written as 4 to the power 5 upon 5 to the power 5. So this is equal to, on further simplification, this can be written as 5 into 4 to the power 5. So this is equal to 5 into 4 to the power 5 is 1024. So on multiplying this, you will be getting rupees 5120. Hence, the estimated value of the machine at the end of 5 years is Rs. 5120. So this completes the solution.